Hello everyone, this video is being brought to you by Law School 101. I'm Ocean. I had secured AIR 99 in CLAT 2018 and I'm currently studying in Lalsar University of Law, Hyderabad. In this video, we'll be discussing one word substitutions. These are important as they might come in your logical reasoning or basically your reasoning section or your English section, and these might even come in the GK section. So these are important in that way. So let's begin with the video without further ado. So also one thing I have divided this video into two parts so that it does not get very big or tedious for you to watch videos. So I have broken this video into two parts. This is the first part and I'll make the second part just after this. So make sure you watch both the parts and let's start now. So first one is a person who has an obsessive wish to steal. That person will be called kleptomaniac. The synonyms for robbery are pilferer, moonlighter, embezzler, and larcener. Okay, so synonym for a robber are these pilferer, moonlighter, embezzler, and larcener. Now, the way you would study this is, see, let's say I come to this slide where I read out the thing. So if I read out a person who has an obsessive wish to steal, what you got to do is, I'll pause for a few seconds and in that you can just think of the answer. If you know anything about it, just think of it in your mind before I move on to the next slide, so that in that way it will be interactive studying. Okay, you'll be interacting with me indirectly in your mind, alright? So it would be good. And if you need time, you can just pause it on this slide and then go on to the next slide, alright? So that's how I would suggest you go through this. These two videos, alright. So let's move on. So that was kleptomaniac. Next is to dig out a dead body from the earth. To dig out a dead body from the earth. Okay, the answer is exhume. Exhume. Okay, now if you have seen the root videos, where I discuss some root words, HUM means earth or soil, and X means to extract. So extracting from the earth is digging out the dead body from the earth, that is exhume, alright? So try to remember it like this. The synonyms are disinter, dig up, unearth, uncharnel, and resurrect. Okay, resurrect is not the exact synonym but close. Alright, let's move on. The original inhabitants of a country are called. The original inhabitants of a country are called aboriginals. Alright, aboriginals. The synonyms are indigenous, native, or endemic. Next up, we have an apparatus for making copies of stencils. Stencils is called. So basically, this is a machine or an apparatus which makes copies of stencils. I hope you know what stencils are. Alright. So the answer is mimeograph. Mimeograph. M-I-M-E-O, mimeograph, alright, so this is a mimeograph. Moving on, one who does not accept the established church. So, what would you call the person who does not accept the established church? So, the answer is atheist. The synonyms are unbeliever, heretic, skeptic, doubting Thomas, infidel, heathen, pagan, libertine, and nihilist. Alright, so these are the synonyms for atheist. So atheist is a person who does not believe or accept the established church. Alright, so atheist. Let's move on. Collector of coins and stamps is called. This one is an easy one. So collector of coins and stamps is called numismatist. Right. So one who collects coins and stamps is called numismatist. Moving on. A delusional mental illness in which a person believes himself or herself to be God or specifically chosen by God for some purpose. Alright. So in this mental illness, now talking of mental illnesses and phobias and all that, I have made separate videos for them, phobias and illnesses and manias. So you can watch those videos as well if you want to cover them separately. I have covered them separately with synonyms and all right, so you can watch it there. So a delusional mental illness in which a person believes himself or herself to be God. Okay, so the person believes he's God, or he believes that he's specifically chosen by God and then sent for some purpose and all that crap. Alright, so that mental illness or mania would be called theomania. Alright. Now, next up, we have a designated room for washing plates, pots, etc. Now, it is mostly in the mostly attached to the kitchen only. So, it's a room for washing plates, pots, etc. The answer is scullery. Scullery. S-C-U-L-L-E-R-Y. Scullery. So, this is this sort of room where all these pots and dishes and all it is washed here. All right. Next, we have an instrument for measuring high temperatures from a distance, alright? So, it's an instrument, okay, which measures high temperatures from a distance. So, you are at a distance from something burning or something, I don't know, anything which has a high temperature, and you measure it through this device. So, what is that instrument or device called? It's called pyrometer. So, here you can see, it's a pyrometer. And what you do is basically you aim it at the source of heat or the thing of which you want to measure the temperature, and you get the reading on this display here. So that's pyrometer. Now these are some other meters, instruments and apparatuses which are used to measure some important things. I thought we should cover them, a part of the static GK obviously, and these can be important also. So let's cover them one by one. So first is fathometer, F-E-T-H-O, fathometer. It measures ocean's depth. Okay, so fathometer measures ocean's depth. Accelerometer measures physical acceleration. All right, easy one. Glucometer measures the blood glucose in blood. Glucose in blood. Okay, so it measures blood sugar. Glucometer. Odometer measures the distance traveled. Geiger counter, G-E-I-G-E-R, Geiger counter measures the ionizing radiation, okay, like alpha, beta, gamma, etc. So it measures these ionizing radiations. Bolometer measures electromagnetic radiation. Catharometer measures composition of gases. Actinometer measures the heating power of sunlight. Alright, so if you want to measure the heating power of sunlight, you measure it through an actinometer. Alcohol meter, I don't know, it is just pretty apparent that it measures the alcoholic strength of liquids. So alcoholometer, I guess. Anyway, next, hydrometer. Hydrometer measures the specific gravity of liquids. All right, so basically it measures the density of liquid. If you want to measure which liquid is at what density, how dense is a liquid, so you do it by a hydrometer. Next is altimeter. Altimeter measures altitudes of mountains or basically anything tall. So altimeter measures altitudes or height. Okay. Dumpy leveler measures horizontal levels. Dynamometer measures force, torque or power. Alright, force, torque or power. Lux, L-U-X, lux meter measures intensity of light. Alright, so how you can remember this is you have a lux sensor in your smartphones which measures the light, and it adjusts the brightness of the screen accordingly using that. Like if you are in a very dark environment, it will change the display lights accordingly. So that's a lux sensor. So a lux meter is basically measuring the intensity of light. Magnetometer measures the strength of magnetic fields, and mammometer measures the pressure of gas on it. Next, we have a few more. Voltmeter measures the electric potential voltage. Electric potential voltage is measured by voltmeter. Tachometer measures the revolutions per minute, rate of blood flow, and speed of airplanes. I don't know how it measures all three, but it does. So, it measures RPM, rate of blood flow, and speed of airplanes. Saccharometer, I guess. Measures the amount of sugar in a solution. So if you want to measure the amount of sugar in a solution, you do it through this. Now this one is important, I mean not important, but the spelling is important, I guess. So sphygmomanometer measures blood pressure. Seismometer measures seismic waves. Brannock device measures shoe size. All right, so now why I took this is very often we go to these showrooms which is, let's say, sells footwear and all, and we see that thing where you can just put your shoe and there is some scale like things here. So I always wondered what that is called. So that's called Brannock device. So next time you go somewhere, next time you go footwear shopping, remember this Brannock device. It measures the shoe size. Sorry, ammeter measures electric current, anemometer measures wind speed, and astrolabe measures the latitude and altitude of celestial bodies. Sorry, astrolabe. Okay, now returning back to our questions, a place where birds are kept, pretty easy one. A place where birds are kept, aviary. Got it? Aviary. Next, a person who attacks or criticizes cherished beliefs or institutions. The answer is iconoclast. Iconoclast. A funeral bell is called. So this is this funeral bell which is rung when someone dies. Alright. So I think it's a set of bells. So what are these bells called? It's called knell. K-N-E-L-L. Knell. Alright. So a death knell is rung immediately after death of a person to announce it. So if a person dies, these bells are rung to announce that someone has died. Alright. So knell. K-N-E-L-L. Next we have the science of earthquakes. The science of earthquakes is called seismology. Alright, seismology. Now just a fact related to it is John Milne, M-I-L-N-E, John Milne was the English seismologist and geologist who invented the first modern seismograph and promoted the building of seismological stations. So now I hope you know what seismograph is. So you can basically monitor the vibrations of the earth to get the intensity of the earthquake which is going to come, which is going to happen or has happened. So that's how you measure the intensity of an earthquake, through a seismograph, by measuring the seismic waves. All right. So John Milne was the inventor of the first modern seismograph. Sorry. Next is a person living in the same time as another. So if you and I, we are living in the same time, right? So we will be called contemporaries. Contemporaries. The synonyms are peers, fellows, compeer, evil, concurrent, and coexistent. So contemporary, a person living in the same time as another. Let's move on. A form of government in which power is held by the nobility. So these are forms of government, pretty easy ones. So in which power is held by the nobility, it's aristocracy. Aristocracy, the powers are held by the aristocrats. Aristocrats are also called the nobility, the peerage, the gentry, the patricide. Patricide is something different. Okay. So the patriciate, the hot monde. This one is important, the hot monde, and the beau monde. Call it. So these are the synonyms for aristocrats. Let's move on. A person who speaks for another is spokesman. Spokesman speaks for someone else. So if I'm speaking for you, I'll be your spokesman. All right. So synonyms would be mouthpiece, voice, frontman, negotiator, and go-between. All right. Now we'll move on. One who cannot be changed or reformed. So let's say you are a criminal and you commit an offense, and I send you to jail in a hope that you will be reformed and you'll understand what you did, and now you'll be a better human after coming back. But you again commit that crime and you keep committing that crime. So what would you be called? One who cannot be changed or reformed. So you'll be called incorrigible criminal or whatever. So incorrigible is the word. The synonyms are inveterate, hardened, irredeemable, one who cannot be redeemed back, intractable, deep dyed. Died, not D-I-E-D, died, that D-Y-E wala die. Okay, died in the wool, impenitent, uncontrite, unrepentant, unapologetic, and unashamed. So these are the synonyms of incorrigible. Let's move on. One who cuts precious stones is called lapidist. Alright, so he cuts and carves precious stones and gems. So lapidist. Moving on, government by the populace, or also called as mob rule, is what? So again, a form of government. What is the form of government which is run by the populace or the mob? The answer is ochlocracy. Ochlocracy is basically government by mob or mob rule, right? So ochlocracy. Now next one, a title or membership of a group given to someone without their needing to have the necessary qualification, usually because of their public achievements, used to describe and also used to describe an official job that is done without a payment. So when you are given a membership or a title, not because you are qualified enough for that, but because you have achieved something in the public arena, and therefore you're given that as a token of respect or as a token of appreciation, or it's an official job that is done without payment. So you do something and you don't charge for it, and you're doing for public benefit or the benefit of the society. So what would that be called? It would be called an honorary job. Alright, so doctors do it all the time. They just go to villages, set up camps, and just give free medicines, give free healthcare and diagnosis, and that would be called an honorary job because they are doing it for the society. They are contributing to the society, and it would be honorary job. Next, a person sent as a diplomatic representative on a special mission, what would he be called? A person sent as a diplomatic representative on a special mission, he'd be called an emissary. E-M-I-S-S-A-R-Y, emissary. Synonyms would be envoy, ambassador, diplomat, delegate, attaché, alright, and legate. So these are the synonyms. Next is the act of violating the sanctity of the church. So the act of violating the sanctity of the church is, blasphemy. Alright, so the synonyms are profanity, profaneness, sacrilege, irreligiousness, and irreverence. Irreverence means lack of respect, right? So the act of violating the sanctity of church, blasphemy. Next we have a similar one, similar to the previous one which we discussed, incorrigible. So one who relapses into previous behavior or condition, especially a habitual criminal. Alright, so what would that person be called? He'd be called a recidivist. Alright, so he again and again commits the same crime or different crimes and doesn't really consider going on the straight path. So he would be called a recidivist. Next, we have a thing to be corrected, typically an error in the book. So what would that be called? Corrigendum, I believe. So corrigendum. Next, we have a state or country run by the worst, least qualified, or the most unscrupulous citizens. So what would that country or form of that government called? It would be called kakistocracy, where the government or the state is run by the least qualified and the most unsuitable persons. So kakistocracy. Next, the time spent recovering from an illness or medical treatment. Alright, what would that be called? It would be called convalescence. The synonym is recuperation. Alright, so convalescence or recuperation. Next, we have a state, society, or group governed by old people. So old people are in charge, basically. So that would be called gerontocracy. Call it gerontocracy. Next, we have a person who can use either hands with ease. So he can use both hands, he can write with both the hands, he can draw, paint, or just use both the hands effortlessly. So that person would be called ambidextrous, alright. Next, we have a person who believes in or tries to bring about a state of lawlessness. He would be called an anarchist. Now, in the true form of the definition of anarchism, I don't think this is a well suited one, and you will study that, like, in coming time you will study that anarchism is not even about a person who tries to bring a state of lawlessness. I mean, obviously that person wants no authority over him, but the statement is a bit flawed, and it depicts anarchists in a bad light, I believe. So anyway, anarchism, you'll study about it, and you can even study about it right now. Just do a Google search, you'll know. But anyway, let's move on. Sound of crickets is called, the sound that crickets make is called what? Creak, C-R-E-A-K, creak. Alright, these are crickets, and creak is the sound they make. Next, an examination of tissue removed from a living body to discover the presence, cause or extent of a disease is called. So, basically to test the, so you want to discover the presence, cause or extent of a disease, how much it is spread within the body. So, you remove a living, you remove a tissue from a living body. What would that procedure be called? It would be called biopsy. Call it biopsy. Next, one who is bad in spellings, what would he be called? He or she be called? The answer is cacographer. C-A-C-O, cacographer. Next, a person who is blindly devoted to an idea, or a person who is displays aggressive or exaggerated patriotism. So he is very blindly devoted that, okay, this is the right thing and everyone has to do it, and he gets very aggressive in that, in the pursuit of that idea. So what would he be called? The answer is chauvinist. All right. So you have linguistic chauvinism, you have patriarch chauvinism, all that. All right. So chauvinist. The synonyms are jingoistic, sectarian, isolationist. I'm sorry. Flag waving, patrician, partial, prejudiced, biased, discriminating, and bigoted. All right. Next, we have a person who is always dissatisfied and rebellious. So one who is never satisfied and is always complaining and always rebelling against something or the other, what would that person be called? The answer is malcontent. Mal means bad, right? So malcontent. So basically the synonyms are disaffected, discontented, dissatisfied, disgruntled, fed up, restive, displeased, vexed, peeved, picked, P-I-Q-E-D, picked, resentful, dissentious, factious, carping, and nitpicking. Alright, so these are the synonyms. Moving on. A political system based on government of men by God. So basically, the men of God are in charge of the government and the state here in this political system. What would that political system be called? The answer is thearchy. Alright. Theory. Let's move on. A critical judge of any art and craft is called connoisseur. He's also called a gourmet, epicure, or gastronome. Gastronome is basically for food and all that stuff, right? But the broad term would be connoisseur. Moving on. A large building with an extensive floor area, typically for housing an aircraft. So basically, you park your aircraft, so as to say here, I mean, not your aircraft, but aircraft. So, a large building with an extensive floor area, typically for housing an aircraft. It is called hangar, not the hangar, but H-A-N-G-A-R, hangar, right? Sound made by penguins is called honk, right? So, a penguin honks. Moving on. A place where coins, medals, or tokens are made. What would that place be called? The answer is mint, M-I-N-T, mint. Alright, so coins are minted here or made here. Now, the government of India, let's talk about India now. The government of India mint operates 4 mints in the country for production of coins. So, at these 4 mints, coins are produced for our country and our economy. These are located in Mumbai, Maharashtra, Kolkata, Hyderabad, and Noida. Alright, so Mumbai, Kolkata, Hyderabad, and Noida. One who changes his mind too quickly is called. So a person who keeps changing his mind would be called fickle-minded. Alright. Synonyms would be unstable, volatile, and flighty. Next, a man who is womanish in his habits. What would he be called? Effeminate. Alright. So effeminate is the man who is womanish in his habits. Moving on. one who deals with things sensibly and realistically in a way that is based on practical rather than theoretical considerations. So what would he be called? One who is sensible and realistic, and he deals with things in a practical manner rather than theoretical considerations. He'd be pragmatic. Alright, pragmatic. Next, one who is center of attraction, a person or a thing or anything, so which is center of attraction of everyone. That thing would be cynosure. The synonyms are axis, base, capital, core, epicenter, ground zero, locus and nucleus. Alright, so cynosure. So this is the end of the part one. Part one ends here. I'll see you again in the next part. I'll be making the second part shortly. So I'll see you in that part. Thank you so much.